crazy the sort of excuses your mind comes up with to do the things, to keep you from doing the things that you know that you need to do. I almost didn't go to the gym today because I ate blueberries this morning and it left this stain across my hand that looked like a gigantic bruise. My mind's like, oh, well, I don't know. It's weird. I'm going to the gym today at my actual gym, so we get to drive. We'll see if you can stay put in here. People are up early. I will be right back. I want to try something. I have no clue how people do that with a straight face. Maybe I'll keep trying and get used to it. This is our first gym drive. That's exciting. I just got out of the gym and recorded before, but something's going on with the audio, so I'm going to try and be a little more quiet, see if that's a little better. But look, I was trying to think of the best way to deliver this message to you. How to be strategic, to maybe even stimulate some emotion and whatnot, but sometimes you just need a straightforward message and God will use it. So, as we are looking for ways to take control of our minds, I just want to ask you, what are you consuming? Because, you know, if you eat bad foods, if you eat highly processed, sugary foods, there's negative consequences. What happens when you eat those foods? Well, you become low energy. You become lazy. It affects your mental health. High sugar is directly connected with anxiety and I believe also depression. If you eat bad foods, it distorts your body. You gain the weight that you don't want. If you eat bad foods, it destroys you. But when you eat good food, you're strengthened. You are made strong. You build strength. You're energized. You have mental clarity. Getting through the day well is nearly impossible without good food. So I'm going to give you the good source of food that you should be consuming. Because right now, you are feasting on negative thoughts, lies of the devil, perverted music, and just lies about your worth, your value, the ability for God to love you, all of those things. It's no wonder you're anxious. So here's the good source of food. The good source of food is the truth of God. The truth of God is found in the scriptures. So I encourage you to read it daily. Don't overcomplicate it. If you're reading no scripture right now, commit to read one verse if you're in a place like Proverbs, or commit to reading for 5 minutes wherever you are. Don't overcomplicate it. Don't just flip to a random page. Just pick a book and read it until you finish it within scripture. And again, just ask these questions. What does this story say about God? What does it say about Jesus? What does this story say about you or mankind? Is there a sin to avoid, a command to obey, a promise to hold on to? And now that you've heard this truth, how will your life be different? So you could read the word all day, and I promise you, it'll be like putting yourself under the scalpel or the gentle hands of the potter, which is God, and he will mold you into something great as you continue to read. But if you want to get the most out of Scripture, you've got to be somebody that after reading the Word of God, you respond to it with action. The word says avoid cursing, avoid filthy talk. So find a way to cut out the cursing. Find a way to clean up your humor. The Word of God says to love others. Commit to loving somebody this week. Don't overcomplicate it. Ask God and move. Ask God what to do and move. Feast on the Word. Read it multiple times a day. There was this time when I was in college, and my best friend, Joseph, the one who had discipled me, had left. I had recently been broken up with, and I'm sorry if I already told you this story, but I found myself very much alone. The good godly influences that I had were gone. But instead of doing what I normally do during tough times and go and find something dumb to do, I decided to talk to God throughout the day, but also any time that I was alone, sitting upstairs in the cafeteria, alone in my room, alone, anytime I was alone, I would just crack open the Word, like, wow, what did that say today? Wow, that was really good. And I would just talk to God about it. And I didn't even ask those questions. I just read, what did that say? And then I would talk to God about it. Saturate your mind, especially if you're in a place of anxiety. You have all of these influences vying for your and fighting for your attention 24/7 throughout the day. How do you combat that? By saturating your mind in the Word and with God throughout your day. So read the Bible. Tomorrow we're going to talk about prayer, and then the next day we're going to talk about something that will also allow you to just keep the Scriptures on your mind throughout the day. Remember, you're not just a person trying to get by in life. Scripture defines you as a soldier in the middle of a battle, and with that comes rigorous training and a new lifestyle. Read your Bible. For a task today, if you see fit to try it, don't use this video, but pick a book of the Scriptures and read it today. Ask God what He's telling you here. Maybe ask those questions. You might have to rewind. I know I went through it quickly and write them down, but I believe that God will honor all of those decisions, and you are going to see a new you down the road. And a stronger you. But even with you, filled with the Holy Spirit right now, trusting in Christ, I can still tell you, even if you're not reading the Word daily yet, that you really do have this. Fill your mind with positive things, positive food that makes you strong, and watch the change happen. I will see you later.
So, I was gone in Clayton last week, which is why the uploads are just a little bit delayed, and I think it was good that I slowed down during that time, but I lost another pound, maybe half a pound, probably a pound, and so this week, to make sure that I'm not losing muscle, I'm going to keep track of my protein. Good morning. You want to be in the video? No? So I'm going to keep track of the protein, but that is it. I forgot to measure it out. Why are you hiding? And that's just to make sure that I'm preserving muscle while losing this weight. But I'll be back because my wife is going to work and I'm going to pay attention to her. And while I am tracking the protein, it's not going to be like I'm measuring everything out. I just want to know how much I was getting out of these egg whites. But see, like I got a heaping scoop there, probably a little bit more than a serving. So I'm just going to guesstimate, and I'm not going to plug it into any app. I'm just going to keep it in my head because I'm trying to decrease the demands of nutrition as much as possible. I'm going to shake this, but I'm probably going to edit it out if I shake with it. As you go through the workout, you are going to notice that it's going to take quite a toll on your grip strength. And you have two choices with that. A, you can just live with it and do the best that you can with whatever weight you can that your grip works with. Or you can do what I did this time because my grip is always just lagging behind, is get yourself some straps. And this just helps you keep a grip on the bar because you start off with deadlifts and I wanted to go heavier because you're only as strong as your weakest link. And unfortunately, that's my grip right now. I want to be transparent with y'all that though I did lose weight, I did not keep all of my rules while I was there. Even with YouTube, I actually watched quite a bit yesterday. And I want to be transparent with you on that. But with failure, in this sense, you have the choice either to quit and be like, oh man, I failed, I'm the worst. Or you can keep going and accept the grace of God, the same grace that God gives you. I want to be accountable to you by letting you know where I'm at. But I'm back on it, and we're going to do better, and we're going to come back stronger. And that's how it goes for the child of God. If you don't want to do the workouts, I mean, again, you don't have to do the workouts that I suggest. If you are an absolute beginner in the gym, you could take that full body routine, and I'll leave a link to another page that will show you a progression that you can do. So you're only in the gym three days a week. And if you wanted to, only 2 days a week. And you'll be okay. I noticed in the cardio that I'd been putting 20 minutes of cardio. Really, go on a walk with a fast pace. Don't stretch yourself too thin. As somebody with anxiety, you don't need to be stacking upon yourself intensity after intensity. Later down the road, I'm thinking about doing this challenge where we go hard. We don't only have hard lifts, but we do hard things like cold showers, maybe even sleeping on the floor, things like that to build up this mental resilience in our minds. So just wait. Build up these habits by starting off doing these small things that I'm suggesting. And you're going to grow. It might seem agonizingly slow sometimes, but you're going to grow. One last thing, just while you're here, as my captive audience, check this out. One of the benefits of going to church and being in fellowship is that you run into awesome people that care about you. This is homemade sourdough bread that was made by some friends of ours, and I'm probably going to make some cinnamon toast with that, with some stevia instead of sugar. This gift that our friends gave us has fed us for the last 2 or 3 days. So if you're going through this program alone, but you do have somebody in your life that's a believer and would hold you accountable and check on you, that would be amazing. I'm not trying to get an extra person to watch my videos. I just mean like, hey, I have this goal. I want to be better. Can you help me? It'll help you. I'm getting ahead of myself, so I'll just see you tomorrow.